Hello and welcome to Versus. I'm Richa Jain Kalra, and today we are discussing the hot topic of the day, the Hyderabad encounter, which is reverberating across the country. People are hailing it as a medium of instant justice. But is it defeating the rule of law? Is it defeating the idea of India, the kind of justice that should happen? Today, I have three guests with me and a lot of students from Delhi University. We are at the law faculty and we're going to discuss different aspects of this very important issue, which has triggered a national debate. First, I have with me Amita Pitre, who's an expert on gender justice from Oxfam India. I have a couple of students. Sneha Shaji is there from Hindu College, political science student. And I have Akash, who's joining us from law facility, and he's also with ABVP. And a host of other students are here who will express their views. First, I want to come to you, Amita. There has been an inordinate delay in delivering justice, especially in crimes of rape and murder. And we have seen what has happened in Nirbhaya. It's been over 7 years. Justice finally has not been meted out the way it should have been. People are hailing it. People are celebrating in Telangana, in different parts of the country, that this is the way forward. You think this is the way forward, or is it defeating the rule of law?
Of course, it's defeating the rule of law, because encounters themselves are a crime. So how can one crime right another crime? As you rightly put it, we need to see behind the outrage. Why is there so much outrage? Because we haven't really followed the rule of law the way it should have been followed. The FIR was not filed on time. There are several delays in the entire... Look at what happened in Unnao. The girl had to run from pillar to post just to get her FIR filed. Then we are seeing that the victims themselves are further victimized. There's been such a bad trajectory of burning the victims. We cannot even call them survivors any longer. They're really dead. So I think this is very disturbing, and we should certainly not hail what has happened. It is a complete failure of the law machinery. We need to instill confidence in the way we handle these cases.
But another aspect of this is people are saying we are fed up. We are fed up with the inordinate delay that's been meted out to several scores of rape survivors. And now we need something radical to deal with this malaise that is set deep into our society. So let's hear some other voices. What would you like to say? What has happened in Hyderabad? Is it the right thing? Is this the way forward in terms of instant justice, or we need to introspect?
Actually, the thing is, executory action is different from justice. People are thinking that justice is provided. This is not the justice. Mm-hmm. Justice is like, it should be from the mouth of the judge. Mm-hmm. And moreover, circumventing the due process doesn't give a justice. Justice is always a justice, and executory plan is apart from that. I think it is a pre-planned encounter. Mm-hmm. And encounters will not serve justice. And justice should be from the mouth of the judge, which justice should stop the crimes, and justice is not for the crime already done.
So this is circumventing the whole process of law?
No, not exactly. But due process is like, it is also in our law. Hmm. But procedure established should be followed in this case.
I want to know your view. There's been so much anger after Hyderabad rape case came out, and we know NCRB, National Crime Record Bureau, suggests that every 15 minutes a woman, a girl is raped into our country. How do we stop this? People say something radical is needed. What is your take on this?
Okay, so I guess it is very important that the legal machinery be strengthened in such a way that things are not delayed at this level. Because the encounter case, if we look at upon it, somewhere people were fed up that the law does fails to like deliver justice. That is why it has happened. And I guess, what if it fails to create a deterrence for that? What if encounters are also not enough for that?
You are saying this will not serve as deterrence?
Exactly. I hope that it creates as a deterrence, but what if it doesn't create a deterrence, right? What if the encounters also fail to create a deterrence, right?
Also, law was amended after Nirbhaya. A lot of action was said to have taken, but has anything changed on ground? No, rapes are still happening. Despite stringent provisions, rapes are still unabatedly happening in our country. So how do we deal with it? Akash, you want to say something?
Actually, I feel that this act is not good according to law. Mm. Because...
The encounter.
Mm. And if police start delivering justice to everyone, so I don't think there is a need of court and everything. Mm. So there must be a fast-track court and the rape rape victims and should be given justice as soon as possible. So I think this act is not good.
But we've seen the kind of delays. Lakhs and lakhs of cases are pending in Indian courts, and the wheels of slow justice has kind of disappointed a large sections of our society, saying that this is not enough. We need more.
I got your point, but I think for these type of acts, there should be a subsequent courts or anything.
Fast track courts,
or and if police start giving justice, and police capture any of the innocent people and kill them and ask for that we have captured the accused, but the accused is fleeing anywhere. So I think this is not good.
What you're saying, what I understand is these four people who were accused of murder and rape, their crime was not proven in the court of law. So they could have been innocent.
There was a pre-trial.
They could have been innocent, though police claim that they admitted to their crime, they confessed their crime during investigation, but this is before the police. We don't know that.
Yes. There was no trial at all. Huh. So I think there must be a trial first, as a being a law student. So there must be a trial. Then if the guilt is proved, if they are accused, then you can hang them or anything. The way this encounter had taken place, I don't think this is right.
This is right. Another thing, Amita, I want to put to you is that we have seen history of several police encounters, whether it's in Chhattisgarh or other Naxal infested states or in Jammu Kashmir. Several times innocents have been gunned down, and later on inquiries reveal that. We all denounce what happened in Hyderabad with that woman, but we don't know until it's proven.
That's why the rule of law is important, because we don't know that those are the right four people who had committed the crime. I think, therefore, it is important to stick to established procedures. What I also want to say is there is so much outrage on fewer cases, like rightful, but still those are very selective cases. There are more than 900 cases of rape every day in India, and actually there is very little focus on the survivor herself. Now we are all trying to show as though this is solving the problem. No, it doesn't solve the problem. If you give confidence to the survivor, if you help her, if you support her, there will be higher convictions in these cases. Currently, our conviction rate is very low, only 30%. Why? Because the survivor is fighting all alone, a lonely battle. She needs psychosocial support. She needs health care. She needs rape compensation. You know, only about 20% of the...
And she's also looked down upon in several parts of the society.
Yeah, so there is shame linked to sexual assault. There's male entitlement. You know, smaller crimes like sexual harassment, there's high tolerance in society for that. Look at our movies. We kind of eulogize sexual harassment. It's okay to harass the girl. And in such a society, we think if smaller crimes are policed effectively, you will see automatically a deterrent for the bigger crimes. There's often a history. The same people have committed a lot of smaller crimes before they go on to a bigger crime like this. And so
you're saying culprits get emboldened because they're not served justice, because they're not held accountable for their small acts, and this is what emboldens them. And if in this context I can point out, today Telangana police held a press conference, and they, in their defense, said these four people who've been gunned down this morning were hardcore criminals. If they were hardcore criminals, why action was not taken against them earlier? Why they were allowed to roam free?
Where's the transparency in all of this? How do we know that those were the right people to gun down? How do we know that there is not another story, like you mentioned in Chhattisgarh, that's going to be unfolding? The other thing is, all the things that were promised after Nirbhaya, only 17% of the funds for the one-stop centers have been utilized. So where does a girl go if she wants support? Sometimes she needs to think through whether she wants to complain. How does she get that space? There needs to be rape compensation fund functional in all the states. Very small amounts of those budgets have been utilized. There need to be helplines. So there's a lot of support structures which were promised, which have not been given.
What I want to know from you is, there has been a lot of unprecedented public pressure. We all have been angered. This case, Hyderabad, the rape case and murder case, has shook the conscience of the nation. But is this public pressure weighing down on the rule of law?
Of course, this incident is showing that. And I think public pressure should not be dictating how the law unfolds. Public pressure is enough to tell you here is a big problem which you haven't solved. People are really looking forward to solutions. That's all. The role of public outrage should end over there. You cannot allow it to dictate how you run the law machinery.
Because if it's police taking law in its hands in the name of self-defense, then we've seen so many lynchings happen in India. And that has been damaging social fabric of this country like never before. Coming back to this topic today, I want to know from you, if encounters are not the right way to proceed with justice, people are saying we need something radical to deal with rape. Rape has become a malaise that has set its roots deep inside. How do we deal with it?
Actually, well, coming to this case, we can see that as you said, during the Nirbhaya case, after the Justice J.S. Verma committee has said that a series of recommendations for the CCTV cameras installation and all this police patrollings and all in the remote areas, mapping of remote areas, and such recommendations were there, and it is not till date it is not completely fulfilled. If it was fulfilled, maybe this Hyderabad issue, like Hyderabad rape case, would have take place. So the point is that the governments, let it be the central government, let it be the state government, they are not giving actual worth to the issue of women rapes and to the issue.
They're
of
not
girls.
Serious enough.
Yeah, they are not serious enough in such women cases.
When
yeah.
you heard this news of the four accused being gunned down in this morning, what was your first reaction?
The first reaction was really, I was perplexed to hear that news. We are living in a democracy. This is not a police state. So the thing is that after they were shot dead, the scope of a further investigation is like terminated over there. We don't know if these four are the real culprits.
I'd like to tell our viewers that in cases of encounters, police encounters, there are several Supreme Court guidelines which say that if an encounter takes place by the police, there has to be an FIR against the police team and it needs to be investigated. We don't know how impartial that investigation happens to be and who does that. In this case, NHRC, National Human Rights Commission, has taken Suomoto notice of this and they are sending their team to find out what has happened. Let's take some other views.
So when you were asking about the reactions, I would like to tell, I went to my sister in the morning when I woke up and just broke the news to her and that these accused have been killed. She said, "Acha hua." So same was the same reaction I got from my mother. So I think the best judges of this situation has to be women, because the victims of these such kind of grievous offenses are women. So they have to be the best judge. As for the encounter case, the police was on the ground. If we believe them, the accused were trying to flee from the spot. They were attacking the police. So that was the action taken by the police. If we do not believe them, even then, if we say that the police has done this, even then, it is a tight slap on our judicial system. We are lagging behind in delivering justice to the victims. We are slow. We have to take cognizance of that. People are happy. If the people are happy with this, it is a tight slap on the face of our judiciary, of our judicial process, because it is too slow to deliver justice. There's a saying which goes the justice is not only to be done, it is also
seen to be done.
So that way we are lagging behind. We are way behind the other countries when we give examples of the European countries. Right now somebody was saying that we are not a police state, we are not a rape state either. We are not going to take this lying down. Victims have to be given justice, and the perpetrators have to be acted against.
Definitely, victims need to be delivered justice and swift justice, not slow wheels of justice that we've been seeing in our society. But are police encounters the way forward?
That is what I'm saying. If the police has taken such a step, I'm not saying it has. It has done a fake encounter. If it has, then we need to reflect on our judiciary needs to reflect what is it doing. Why is it losing the trust of the people? Why are the people so happy? it's a fact that people are happy. Yes. If you go by what the news channels are showing, they are happy.
People are fed up with the slow justice.
Exactly.
Being
slow justice. We are so slow that Nirbhaya gang rape happened. What has happened to them? Nirbhaya's mother has said that she too is happy with this situation.
Right.
What are we doing?
Exactly. So it's time now for me to take a short break and Versus. We'll be back in few minutes. Stay with us on this debate. Welcome back in Versus. We are debating, is India becoming a mobocracy? The way Hyderabad encounter is being celebrated in different parts of the country, an idea has risen, is rule of law being defeated by public pressure? And I have several students and several experts at Delhi University's law faculty, and let's talk to some students. Yes, what's your opinion? What has happened in Hyderabad? Is the step in right direction, or is this the misuse of law?
No, actually, as being a human being, this is morally right, according to me. When I got to hear this news that they all got fired by police, I was so happy. I was like, finally, mare, because they deserve to be. But as being a lawyer and as being a law student, this is the failure of judiciary. We can say that, because we were waiting for the judgment of judges to restore the faith in the law and order. But according to our population and according to our justice, according to our judges, our law is very slow. We cannot work with it because the rape cases are increasing in every year. We are not stopping it. And if people are criticizing that encounter was not right, we are not the police state, we are not this, we are not that, but actually in the scenario, if we take the point, they just do that thing which was the heat of the motion.
But don't you think you are expressing the opinion of a large number of people who are saying that what has happened is the right thing? But as a law student, as a member of a civilized society, if we allow police to do encounters, aren't we already empowering them more to take law in their hands? They are there to be the guardians of law, not misuse the law. Because we've seen so many examples of law being misused, of doing fake encounters.
According to me, we are saying that all you said, but they didn't take any law in their hand. First, the accused people tried to fire on them. That's why they got encounter in the cross firing.
You are saying as per the theory of the police.
Yeah, we cannot only blame the police for this thing. As Martin Luther King said, the time is always right to do the right thing. So police did the same. So we cannot criticize them. What is done is done. This is superbly good, according to me. I'm not looking for any criticization after this, because I know some people are not happy with it. But if we see, many numbers of people are happy with it, and justice is all over about people's happiness. And if we are happy with this decision, so what's wrong with it?
But what about the idea of justice, the idea of human rights? It's right that those victims also have human rights. Their families also need to have swift justice. But what if they were innocent?
Do you really think they are innocent?
I'm not saying, what if?
They are, actually, if you are burning someone alive, you are not innocent. You are doing rape. If you are even have bad intention about someone, so you are not innocent. You have got the karma you had done. This is the rule of life. And if we see, this is the best lesson to judiciary to do their work in fast.
So you agree with the brutal ways of dealing with rapists?
Yes, I do.
Okay. You agree with brutal ways of dealing with rapists, murders?
Yes, but not such prosecutions, or not such executions. But it should be in the exact way of the rule of law.
You advocate the legal way?
Yes, the legal way only. Yes.
Yes, you want to say something?
So I think, you know, in this context, I would like to highlight that as per the NCRB data, which has come out, the report which has come out, we see that 900 cases of crime is actually rape is happening every day in the country.
And every 15 minutes, a rape is happening in our country, and several of them, scores of them, are not even reported.
So yes, most of them is underreported. So the reported ones are coming to the limelight, and many gets, it's only the tip of the iceberg that we see. So I think, you know, it's a time that we should react to the situation, but not that we take up law in our hands. We should actually follow the due processes, legal processes, rather than taking law into our hands. And also, you know, public is celebrating because they had been waiting for justice. But I think it's important that we do justice to the, you know, whole process, rather than just reacting to the situation. So it's more, the public should be informed that, you know, we should have legal processes, due legal processes to follow, and accordingly react. So that is my reaction to this whole situation, that we, government should respond, preventive mechanisms should be in place, and also responding to.
But why has the government not responded after Nirbhaya? If you have not responded enough after that, what shall we wait for?
So that's what I'm coming to, that the government is not responding to the underutilization of the Nirbhaya fund. We are seeing that. We see that 17% of the funds are only spent on one-stop centers. We know that the helpline is only spending 43% of the amount. So then what is happening in the country? We see that the government is not serious about the issue of violence that is inflicted on women in the country, women and girls in the country. That is the crisis in the country. We should raise to the situation. We should respond. We should follow the due legal processes rather than taking law in our hands.
And now I want to go to Amita. Amita, if people are fed up with slow wheels of justice and they are celebrating this case of instant justice, they are not to be faulted, actually. We all are responsible as a society, because as a state we have failed in delivering justice to those who face rape and murders.
I want to say two things finally. One is, these acts of taking the law into your own hands, or just asking for very brutal punishments like death penalty.
Some MPs were advocating lynchings, castration, and so on.
So actually that discourages women and girls from reporting the crime, because over 90% of these crimes are committed by people they know, family, friends, neighborhood, things like that. So it will actually discourage reporting of crime. That's one. And yes, let's reserve all the outrage for demanding accountability, that procedures be followed, that whatever has been promised after the Nirbhaya incident is followed to the T. Let's reserve our outrage for that. Let's call our MPs to account for that purposes. Ki why isn't the law being followed?
And why not ask our police to file FIRs on time? Not to keep pushing the cases to other police areas, like we saw in this case. The police were not ready to register the FIR initially, saying that it's not their own domain.
Exactly. And this is happening case after case. In multiple cases, we see that the police is not taking the complaint seriously, not filing FIRs. There's this whole provision of zero FIR. You can go and file FIR in any police station, and that has not been followed even here. So that is leading to loss of faith in the system. But we have to reserve our outrage to bring faith back to the system. Let's do it the right way.
Last comment I want to take.
Ma'am, few days back we all are discussing and debating about what should be done to them. Yes. And now when the justice is served to the girl, to the family, now we are debating either they are innocent or not. Mm-hmm. In my opinion, the justice which is given to them, victims, is good. And
you agree with the encounter?
Yeah.
Just one more
final
thing.
Comment.
Final comment. There was a movie called A Wednesday. Nasiruddin Shah was playing a common man. He said, "Ye cockroach mera ghar ganda kar rahe the. Agar aap nahi karenge, to hum saaf karenge. We will do it."
I just have this much time for this debate, but this is an never-ending debate. It's a debate about the human rights of those killed in the name of encounter, and swift justice for those who face this crime, who've been under intense problems, and as a society we have failed them. It's time for us to peep inside how to rectify this rot of murders, of rapes, which are happening every 15 minutes in our state. As democracy, if we are supporting encounters, then we are failing as a lawful state.